Hello. Welcome to This is Southeastern, a news magazine show about Southeastern Regional Vocational Technical High School, entirely produced by students. I'm Erica Caban, and here is Shannon McGlinchey with what's coming up today.
Today we take a look at the various themes of Southeastern's Green Week: reduce, reuse, recycle, rethink, resist. We also get the sights and sounds of this year's Trash and Fashion Show and the Green Fair.
Green Week is a week where students, staff, and faculty are encouraged to be especially environmentally conscious. Each day has a special theme that goes along with being environmentally friendly. Day one's theme was reduce. We spoke with the environmental shop, Ms. Hobbs, about ways we can implement the theme into our everyday life.
It's not easy being green, having to spend each day the color of the leaves.
The theme of reduce is important to Green Week to kick off the week and get people thinking about how they personally can reduce their impact on the environment. We are having a plastic bag monster that's going around that you might meet later today, as well as having a table set up in the cafeteria to get people thinking about how they can reduce their energy usage or how they can reduce their resource needs on the planet. You can reduce by donating things you don't want anymore. You can reduce by using a reusable water bottle instead of buying new plastic bottles. You can reduce by turning off the lights when you leave the room or turning the water off when you brush your teeth. So it can be anything from really small things that you won't even notice a change to really big things by buying all of your produce locally from local farms. I am constantly looking for ways to reduce my needs. So recently, last year, I joined a CSA, which is a community-supported agriculture, which produces local organic produce. And so I'm supporting a local business, and I'm reducing the fossil fuels that are needed to make the food that I eat, as well as the chemicals that are put into the food. So I'm reducing that. I'm conscious about my electric usage in my house, making sure that I turn the lights off when I leave a room or whatever. I'm always looking for new ways.
You wonder why.
Russell.
Why I wonder.
Thanks.
Why I wonder.
The theme of reduce is important to Green Week because we all need to be conscious about our environmental impact and what we're doing with society and with the environment and our impact on it. So we're trying to teach students different ways that they can individually reduce their consumption, because everyone thinks it's just me, it's just one person, what can I do? But we need to figure out how to show them that a collective you can do a lot. You can recycle, you can shut off your lights, you can use reusable water bottles. Instead of using plastic bags, you can use those cloth bags that you can buy at the store, which you can use over and over and over again. You can donate your old clothes. When something rips, you can sew it up. I shut off my lights, I open my windows, I use reusable water bottle, I don't use plastic bags anymore. The point of the plastic bag monster is to show everyone how much plastic bags we use, because everyone thinks they don't use a lot, but this monster was completely made. I have just 5 or 6 students bringing in bags. So if that shows how much we can collect in a week, then you collectively see how many much plastic bags are being used and how much is being thrown away and is going into the environment. And the point of the plastic bag monster was to bring that into awareness and that this needs to stop, and I shouldn't be able to make one of these.
The theme of reduce is important to Green Week because our planet is what matters, and if you use less, we'll live
green
more.
Green can be cool and friendly like. And green can be big, like a mountain.
Day 2 of Green Week's theme was reuse. Students at Southeastern took to some interesting methods of promoting this theme during this week, including a Green Week superhero and its arch nemesis, plastic bag monster.
About Green Week is that we follow rules by recycling, reusing our drinking devices, not devices, bottles, shutting off electricity and not littering, and making sure that everyone doesn't abuse the earth by everything I just said. We can improve the school by, if everyone didn't decide to litter, like in the courtyard, outside, on the field, and if they could just recycle in the recycling bins. We can reuse the plastic bottles you drink over a long period of time. You should definitely buy your own thermos to drink out of. Today's point of Reuse Tuesday is about reusing your drinking devices, water bottles, about going out and buying a thermos for yourself so it doesn't pollute the earth by just wasting your plastic water bottles. It's better to just keep it in your house, use them, and around school, wherever you go. Some other examples is about, other than bottles, say like if you're about cell phones, like my friend said, going out and using a contract, getting a phone every 2 years, you should just keep your phone and use it until it dies. Well, we worked really hard by setting up posters around the school and by choosing out each day what's going on. For instance, yesterday was like lights out day, where you shouldn't use electricity even throughout the week, not just Monday. And today was reuse. Tomorrow we're going to be promoting at a trash and fashion show, and mostly the rest of the week is just speaking out to everyone that they can support and recycle. And the Green Week superhero is my great friend who supports the earth just like we do. Basically, what she was showing you in that skit was that we should not throw away plastic bags. We should keep them, and that's why, as if you would go to a supermarket, you want to get a paper bag, don't want to use plastic. All I can say is that I hope you all read what I just said to you, and go green.
Day 3, the theme was recycling. Recycling is an important aspect of our everyday life.
Hi, my name is Raquel, and this is Southeastern. Today is day 3 of Green Week, and I am here with Miss Esrins, and she's going to talk with us about the Trash and Fashion Week. Turn on your tap
and get hot and cold running. So the Trash and Fashion Show is a chance for my students to explore fashion design, and we come up with a theme, and then they all choose some inspiration to work off of, and then the students that are designers come up with a concept, and they have to create a concept sketch, and from that sketch we look at materials that we can use that are recyclable, and they create their dresses using those recycled materials, and then we put on a fashion show. It is a huge collaborative effort. We work with cosmetology, we work with Mr. Fernandes to help with the theatrical presentation, we work with the environmental students on our environmental message, so it's a huge collaboration amongst the school. Some other shops helped us with some of the things that we needed, metal fab and things like that. And it's young artists using their artistic voice to help promote social change. We're trying to get people to recognize there are a lot of environmental issues, and if we can do things differently at Southeastern, we can have a positive impact. So it's a lot of work, but a lot of fun.
Thank you, Ms. Esrins. And now for the highlights of the Trash and Fashion Show.
We'll be right back. to make the floor shake.
Day 4's theme was Rethink, and Day 5's theme was Resist. And we couldn't resist taking in the Green Fair, an extravaganza of vendors pushing eco-friendly products that capped off Green Week.
We were asked to come and present our club and our efforts in beach conservation throughout the state of Massachusetts. Our cause is having clean, usable beaches for the general public and the fishermen in the state of Massachusetts, and having beach access open to everyone who enjoys the beaches.
I'm here to demonstrate to the students here that there are local foods produced locally. We happen to be the last dairy herd in Norfolk County. There are probably 8 herds in Bristol County, but there are a tremendous amount of local foods available. You can visit local farmers markets throughout eastern Massachusetts. For a list of them, you could look on the Department of Ag Resources, DAR website, and you'll find a tremendous amount of local farmers markets in this region of the state.
I got invited to the fair because I run Stay Vocal, which is a certified green reuse apparel brand. Instead of printing on new garments, we do rescue t-shirts. So half of the garments come from thrift stores and donations, and then the other half come from merchandise companies that are destroying shirts. So I rescue all these shirts and then give them a new life with a second design. Reuse, because you can't recycle the planet.
What brings me here is just to talk about Mass Audubon and what we do at Mass Audubon and our goals. We are for advocacy, conservation, and education of children. So what we really want to see is more kids getting outdoors. Local, I would like to see more children outside and enjoying the natural world and unplugging from all the gadgets.
I was invited because I met some folks at the Connecting for Change conference in the fall, and they asked me if I would come and present some of my products. I grow my own herbs, and I try to use products where there's a surplus, where they need to be preserved. So herbs are really best if they're used in whole leaf form. So I try to promote people to eat the dried herbs rather than buying it crumbled already, like you find in the grocery stores. If you buy it whole leaf, then when you crumble it right before cooking, it's better. So I try to promote using that kind of herb, and I infuse the herbs into my jellies. And so I think they thought that these were good products to showcase for a green event. I think just reducing waste is probably, you know, I initially started my business with the herbs and putting them into the jellies, but I had a lot of surplus, so I started packaging them, and they were well received, and that's when I started promoting the whole herbs, because I was surprised at how much interest there was by the public. And so that just gave me another excuse to grow some more because I had a use for them. But I don't like to see anything go to waste. So sometimes I'll be at a farmer's market and they will say, like a new farmer had grown some banana peppers last year and she had trouble selling them. And I said, well, why don't we see what we can do? So we dried some that we sell in a dried form, and we made a banana pepper jelly, which turned out to be fabulous. So that's the kind of, I don't know if that's a cause, but that's, you know, I don't like to see waste. I like to support local farmers, local growing, and local eating. And so if there's a way to preserve and I can be a part of that, I guess that would be my cause.
Because I'm here with the Mass Save program, and what we do is we try to save energy and help make homes more energy efficient. So we just come out to your house, we place all your light bulbs and stuff, give you all these power strips, these energy efficient stuff, just to help save energy and lower your utility bills each month for homeowners. And we're here with the school to, every time a parent signs up for a free home energy assessment, they get $10. We donate $10 to the school. Get your free home energy assessment. You're going to love it. I had mine, too.
I'm here to spread the word about Simpson Spring, the oldest bottling plant in the country. I'm promoting our soda and our spring water. Personally, yeah, that's what I'm here for.
So many different vendors, different people engaging, learning about all of the dimensions of green and what they can do to be more sustainable and make the planet a happier, healthier place. That's what I do. That's my job. It's my life. It's my everything. So I depend on it for my food, my water, my shelter, everything. So
So I'm here representing the Department of Conservation and Recreation, which is a state agency within the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And I actually work with the environmental sciences shop here at the school. We have Ms. Hobbs' class come out and do some work in some of the state parks, including some vernal pool certification and invasive species monitoring. So she requested that I come here with information about the state parks so that the students know what kind of state parks are available in that area and what kind of activities can be completed at our state parks. So we promoted stewardship of green space as well as protection of endangered species, removal of invasive species, so habitat enhancement, and then protections of wetlands through vernal pool certification. Just feel free to come by our booth or just look us up online, the Department of Conservation and Recreation. We have over 450,000 acres in the state. It's about 85 different parks throughout the state that offer any kind of opportunity, including skiing, cross-country skiing, ice skating, canoeing, kayaking, camping, hiking, dog walking. I mean, you name it, any kind of outdoor recreational activity, our facilities will be offering that. They're all at a reduced cost or free of charge because we're here for the benefit of the Commonwealth. So definitely look us up. And if you want to go camping, you can go to Reserve America. It's extremely affordable to go camping. Or if you want to go out and check out some of the state parks in your neighborhood, then definitely, you know, go to the website. It's all on there.
Well, this is it for This is Southeastern. Remember, you can check out past and current episodes of This is Southeastern online.
We'd like to thank Ms. Hobbs, the environmental shop, and everyone who helped out with this episode today.
I'm Erica Kamon.
And I'm Shannon McGlinchey, and thanks for watching.